just an amazing, amazing man. I mean, if you read that story, you're saying, wow, wait a minute. Now let me get this straight. 20 years in prison.
Actually, only 19 years, 6 months, and a week.
And I think we talked a little bit about it. It was kind of like a white collar crime, but you also were involved busting the drug cartel and all that.
Yeah. It was just at the wrong place at the wrong time with a stolen business jet, a bag of cash, and Mercedes Benz, and they kind of swooped in on me in planes, trains, and automobiles, kind of screwed Uzis into my ears, ruined my orange juice this morning, didn't pass code, didn't collect $200, went directly to jail.
And they didn't let you have any soon?
No.
But while I was incarcerated, his life truly changed. Tell us about that.
The Lord visited me in such a way that it's kind of like a Saul on the road to Damascus type experience, and got knocked off my high horse of pride, blinded by the light, and came up and turned to Jesus and never turned back again.
That's awesome. You know, in reading your story, as people, it is amazing what transpired not only while you're in the jail, in one of the prisons, but how you were able to impact those other inmates. And then something came across your heart about the Bible. Tell us about that. I'd like to share that.
I was minding my own business in a prison cell in Leavenworth Penitentiary when I had this visitation from the Lord. And this tree of books sprouted up out of the ring finger of my right hand and then reached the nations. And I remember coming out of that vision saying, Lord, I don't want to be a writer. I don't even like to read. And the audible voice of God spoke back to me, just as it was told to Joseph, it shall be done. So being a young Christian, it took me about 2 days to find Joseph in the Bible. And I found out that, he went from the pasture to the pit, to the Potiphar's house, and then to the prison house, then to the palace of the prime minister, and I'm like, interesting. So eventually God gave me a desire to read and to write, and since then many books have been written. But our main line ministry is Bibles, changing lives one Bible at a time. We do first quality leather-bound Bibles to the prisoners. We dress people not for the job they have, prison, we dress them for the job they want, which is God's calling on their life, whatever that is individually. And we give them leather-bound Bibles because the average prison sentence in the federal system is 10 years. They do about 8 years, 8 months, and paperbacks wear out pretty quick. So we like to give them a Bible with all the lights, bells, and whistles. And when they get that and they smell that leather-bound Bible, it reminds them of quality and freedom. And it tells them who they are. I know when I got my first leather-bound Bible about 8 months after I was born again, that when I got that, I felt equipped and I felt somehow like I had the armor of God, or I was just a different level of believer. I just felt like it was a game changer for me.
And you're like became evangelist right inside the walls of the prison. But since then, I understand that you've given over 5,000 Bibles away, is that correct?
Our ministry has, and the Real Hope Heroes are the nameless, faceless people behind the scenes at Heart of America Prison Ministries. God made me the face, but the real body parts are the ones that bring it to pass and get
your parents.
Including my parents, and now, for whatever reason, God has chosen to expand our ministry into about 1,200 prisons across the United States, 18 internationally. So God is expanding Heart of America Prison Ministries, and the tree of books that God showed me coming out of my right hand, he seems to be bringing that to pass by his hand.
And you're pursuing business opportunities as well. This man's really making up for lost